Susan just heard us setting up in the studio. Here she comes. Aristotle thought the brain was only a type of radiator, a radiator for the heat, to dissipate the heat and cool the blood from the rest of the body. René Descartes, the famous French scientist, gave it a little more respect, concluding that it was a sort of antenna by which the spirit might commune with the body. It's only now that the full wonder of the brain is being realized. So, the brain, obviously, it is intimately, if not solely, centuries ago. And so, it was slow work because the scientists, after they had maybe mapped out certain areas that were aberrated or changed due to traumatic brain injuries, they would slowly piece together which area of the brain does what. But then, of course, they'd have to wait till their patients completely died. Dissect the brain and really understand what was happening internally. And of course, that's only if they were allowed to. Because of course, from the just like we're, you know, interested in how our body metabolizes all the food we intake so that we can live a pristine, healthy, long, thriving, prosperous life. A life that we feel good about. And so that we can feel good and healthy and move our bodies around and not be in pain. And that same more mechanical and chemical thrive, yearning to understand our body. I think the amygdala and all these especially ancient structures in our brain, all these primordial, primitive, prehistoric, mammalian, and reptilian brain parts, I think these can all give us immense, unimaginably immense and deep insight into just how it is we view the world on a psychological level. So, for mental and physical health is the approach, is my perspective to being so interested in the brain. So these stimuli are turned into emotions in the amygdala, and it's tiny, but it says it punches well above its weight. And then we have the hippocampus, which can retrieve a memory. And then we have the prefrontal cortex, which we know helps make moral judgments. And this is the crazy part here, that can actually recognize nerve firing patterns. Or, yeah, just patterns, I guess, in the brain. I can see nerve endings firing along well-known neural pathways when they associated with amusement, empathy, and even the thrill of schadenfreude at the sight of an adversary being defeated. So, a picture is slowly being revealed as the studies of the brain show it to be an astonishingly complex, sensitive system in which each part affects almost every other part. So high-level cognition performed by the frontal lobes, for instance, feeds back to affect sensory experience. So what we see when we look at an object is actually shaped by expectation, as well as by the effect of light hitting it and bouncing off it into our retina. So when you see a glass, your brain automatically primes itself to make a hand movement to cup it. And we have motivational systems in it. So when I see a glass and I'm thirsty, I'm much more prone to look at the glass than I am the rectangular box shape that has no chance in hell of holding a glass of water, of holding water in it. Whereas the glass, of course, A, it contains water, but B, it has, even if it was empty, it has the capability of containing water. just like when we look at a book. You know, a child might look at a book who isn't a young enough child and just see a very uninteresting, again, rectangular block shaped thing that they might be able to open up and make weird noises with. But we know from experience stop at the neck, but extends to our toes and our fingertips, and some would argue that it even goes beyond to encompass other minds with which it interacts. This is awesome. So, brief history of it. Discovering that the brain has very cells are independent elements in the basic units of the brain. He wins the Nobel Prize for that. Sigmund Freud abandons an early career in neurology to study psychodynamics. The success of Freudian psychoanalysis eclipsed physiological psychiatry for 50 years, half a century. Then we have nerve cells starting to be probed. Alzheimer describes a pre-senile degeneration named after him. And then, right before the outbreak of the First World War, we have British physiologist Henry Allendale isolates acetylcholine, the first of the neurotransmitters to be discovered. That's so fascinating. So now we're discovering increasingly higher resolution elements of the brain. Then we have the visual cortex, the first electroencephalograms. Then we have and most of the rest of these are just discussing the technological breakthroughs. So all of these are more landmarks in neuroscience. And also